Let's convert a VHF UHF antenna to 868 MHz to use with Meshtastic. To do this, you will need a few simple tools, such as a pair of cutters and a craft knife, as well as a Nano VNA or comparable analyzer and a SMA male to SMA male coupler. This will allow you to modify antennas designed to be used on VHF and UHF handheld transceivers, such as the popular Baofeng radios on a Meshtastic node. In this particular example, I will be modifying a Nagoya 144 and 430 MHz antenna. The antenna as standard is not designed to be used on 868 MHz, so before we can use it, we must try and reduce the SWR measurement. To achieve this, we can use a device such as this Nano VNA that can measure and visually plot the resonance of an antenna, as demonstrated here using a tuned, stock antenna. Now let's check the SWR of the Nagoya antenna as it stands, but first we will need to connect the SMA adapter. Luckily, as we will also be using the same adapter when fitted to the Meshtastic node, we won't need to calibrate the Nano VNA to account for it. However, if that were not the case, the Nano VNA should be calibrated each time. The same goes for using a feeder or cable between the antenna and the Nano VNA. As you can see, the SWR is currently measuring between 5 and 7. When it comes to SWR, lower is better, with 1 being perfect, and anything above 2 considered less than ideal. So let's see how much better we can get this antenna to resonate on 868 MHz. First, we need to remove the plastic end cap. This may be glued on and require a little heat to slide off cleanly. As you can see, the internal construction of this antenna is basically twisted brass wire. The idea with this method is simply to ever so slightly reduce the length of the wire and reanalyze its SWR measurement in an attempt to get as close to 1 as possible. The cutter on these combination pliers eventually got the job done, but a more substantial pair of cutters would have been beneficial for this task. So since I'm not monetized, I'll speed this bit up. Now let's see what difference those few millimeters made and test the antenna again on the Nano VNA. As you can see, the reading is now between 4 and 6, so we are moving in the right direction. Now we need to repeat the process again and remove a little more. The next attempt, and it's down to between 3 and 4. Let's repeat. As you can see, the antenna is now reading a SWR of around 3.1, 3.2. While the SWR is still not ideal, you have to bear in mind that at some point, as the antenna becomes shorter and shorter, the SWR will begin to rise as you take more and more off, and the results you get with this method will vary depending on the antenna. Now just carefully remove a little of the outer sleeving of the antenna with a craft knife and fit the plastic cap. At this point, it's important to retest the antenna, as the nib and sleeving is enough to affect it. Although with this antenna, I couldn't get it below 2, I did reduce the SWR of this particular antenna by around 50%. I will be testing this antenna and comparing it against a few others in an upcoming video, so please press like and subscribe if you have a spare second or two. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe for more Meshtastic content.